little closer, so next time we're going to plan a little ahead. So go ahead and shorten your reins, remember how I showed you? Grab the bolt and then grab that loophole straight up. And so grab the bolt.
Hang on.
That was true.
Then you try. I know I'm walking at you, but you try.
So grab both like this. And this hand is,
Nope, that's just for shortening your reins. So it's going to have you shorten your reins because he's going to be growing you.
So you're going to keep your hands right here like this. So that when you pull out your feet, something extra.
Okay. Perfect. So don't want to pull those reins out of your hands. What he's going to do,
you pull out the push and pull out and try to get an inch from you. And then he's going to get an inch from you.
She's thinking about it that time.
Her ears aren't as pinned back as they have been.
So while you're right here, the wall side will go out. Turn your toes towards me. Like, turn your toes out like this, like it has on your body. What happened to your whole leg? Your knee came off the water, so your leg better knee came off, right? But when our toes are forward, what happens to our leg? Goes in, yep. Good. So we also want to, when we're riding, I just had to look in here a few things, right? Average human head, approximately 12 pounds, okay? So if you're doing this, yes, they feel that. But watch my legs. I'm sitting on my horse and riding, and I want to turn. What happens when I turn my whole body? I use that leg without even realizing I'm using that leg, and my hand comes out over my knee, right? So look at that eyeball in the chest and look.